Ask.
I do, Mr. Chairman.
Clerk will report the title of the amendment.
Amendment to the committee print for H.R. 212, offered by Mr. Sarbanes.
Mr. Chairman, I reserve a point of order.
Point of order is reserved. The clerk will read the title of the amendment. Without objection, the amendment is considered as read. Gentleman is recognized for 5 minutes in support of his amendment.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This amendment is being offered to require the Environmental Protection Agency to develop a strategic plan for assessing and managing drinking water-related risks associated with hydraulic fracturing operations. The practice of hydraulic fracturing, which has become quite pervasive now, is having a significant positive impact on our energy security. We know that. But the regulation of fracking has not kept pace with that, and there are concerns about the impact it has on drinking water. As it happens, EPA is currently working on a study of the drinking water impacts of fracking. That study, which we expect to be completed this spring, will outline the mechanisms by which fracking impacts drinking water supplies. Because of EPA's extensive work preparing that study, we know already that there are impacts at all stages of the fracking process. At the beginning of the process, there are significant amounts of water which are drawn from aquifers, which potentially impacts drinking water supplies. At the end of the process, there are large amounts of wastewater that are sent for disposal, potentially overwhelming wastewater treatment works and dumping pollution into our surface waters. And of course, throughout the process of fracking, the fracking itself and surface spills of fracking fluids, which we've seen occur, do pose some serious risks. There's long been as well an absence of real transparency around what chemicals fracking companies are mixing and injecting into our ground, but we know that many of them do pose risk to drinking water. I want to emphasize, I support this bill, the underlying bill, which pairs assessment and management of drinking water impacts. For fracking, EPA has been hard at work on the assessment side, as I indicated, but doesn't have in place a strategic plan to manage the drinking water impacts that have been or will be identified. That's why I'm offering the amendment, to ensure an effective response to protect public health. I do want to mention that the Chesapeake Bay watershed, which I and other members whose districts intersect with it jealously seek to protect. The footprint of that watershed is New York, Pennsylvania, Virginia, West Virginia, the District of Columbia, Maryland, and Delaware. The footprint of the Marcellus Shale deposit is New York, Pennsylvania, Virginia, West Virginia, and Maryland. So you have almost a complete overlap of the watershed and the Marcellus Shale deposit, which means it's really critical that we understand what negative impacts can come from fracking, particularly in the region that I'm speaking about. So this is a common sense opportunity for us to get the kind of management of the impacts of hydraulic fracturing on drinking water. And I think that if you sat with certainly any one of my constituents, and I think the average citizen out there, and said, the EPA is doing this study, they're going to determine what the impacts of fracking are on drinking water, and we think it's a good idea to have a strategic plan in place to manage those risks and potential harms going forward, they would say that's absolutely a common sense thing to do and would support it. And for that reason, I urge my colleagues to vote yes on the amendment, and I yield back.